I was always musical. Back in high school, I was a singer and guitar player in a band called Grease Lightning. Yes, that is me. I was tending bar in Boston. And honestly, there are days when I say, maybe I should be doing that again. My roommate at the time was a general contractor, and he was building a store for a company called Tweeter, etc. So during the days, I would go help build the store, and I met the owner of the company, and he kind of liked what I did, and he made me an offer to be the general manager of the very store we were building. And I went, what the heck, maybe I can actually like have a nightlife as opposed to work nights and sleep days. I went from running all the stores for Tweeter, etc., to media systems, and I ran that for about 15 years. We had our office in the Boston Design Center. You know, nowadays you go, well, of course you work with the design community. But back then, they wanted nothing to do with us. At Media Systems, we had a lot of firsts. This old house was one of them. So we were in Boston.
Mitch and Steve Hayes designed that great media room we had down on our Milton project. You made us all jealous with that one.
We were the first AV company to actually get involved with this old house. We really hit it off. So we did about 4 episodes with them. We were the very first CE Pro Dealer of the Year. And then the next first was when we were the first Lutron Radio Raw installation, which was actually my house. I exposed my family to a lot of technology, a lot of crap, a lot of really good stuff, and they were my test bed. Dorothy, just always encouraging and always nurturing and always trusting my view and my vision. And on the flip side, I made damn well sure I coached Little League. I coached their games. I was very, very involved. And I exposed them to the world of Cedia.
And Zach is quite a remote lover, right?
Actually, that's the first thing he went for. We'll be walking his room as he saw this one.
I helped to bring URC from a handheld remote control company to a whole house control company. I brought them into the Z-Wave world and then had an opportunity to move from URC into the Silicon world. When I first took over the Alliance almost 5 years ago, there were about 240 members. I brought it up to over 700 members. We have 3,000 certified devices that are specifically designed for the smart home. So it's been quite a wild ride. I became Cedia treasurer in 1994, vice president for 2 years, then in 1997 I became president and was president for 2 terms, 97 through 99. Since I came on board, we have been debating certification. I said, okay, incoming president, we're going to do it or we're not going to do it. It's going to happen under my watch. And again, there were a lot of others that really did the work. There was legislation in my home state of Massachusetts. Rhode Island had already passed legislation that essentially would have put all of us out of business. So one of the first things I did was saying, we're going to address this. We have to protect our members. We have to get involved. The way to learn and be successful is to surround yourself with people who are smarter, perhaps more talented, have better vision, or different vision, if you will. The piece that I love so much about working with Cedia, working with the other volunteers and bringing people in and recognizing other people's passion, being able to bring them in and leverage that passion and let them run with it. Open it up, don't shut it down. I love the creating. I love the fact that what we're doing has never been done before. That's the part I like. I don't do anything that's already been done. I love the relationships. I love meeting the new people. The biggest value has been the camaraderie, the friends that I have made, the things I have learned from them, the experiences that have been shared. You cannot get that in any way anywhere else. Cedia is where you get it.